In order to find the principal stresses and maximum in-plane shear stresses based on the stress element shown in the figure, we can utilize Mohr circle for this purpose. So to start, let us first identify the stresses along the x and y direction. Since along the x direction, that is the horizontal, we have our normal stress of 100 megapascal, we represent it as sigma x. Similarly, along the vertical direction, we have our sigma y value of 20 megapascal. Next, I have a shear stress value acting on our xy plane going downward on the right hand side of the square. Since it is going downward, based on the sign convention, it is taken as negative. Next, let's go ahead and plot our axis for the circle. So our horizontal axis is given as the normal stress sigma is taken as positive to the right, whereas the vertical axis is taken as shear stress positive downward. Once we have the axis, let's go ahead and identify the center point of the circle. So the center point coordinates are given as sigma average comma zero, meaning that I have the average normal stress as the center point, whereas the shear stress is equals to zero where the center point lies. In this case, the average value of normal stress is coming as 60 megapascal. So we can go ahead and identify that point on our graph and mark that thing as C. Next, once we have the center point, we have to identify a reference point in order to calculate the radii. Now, for reference point, we can pick the right hand side of the square. On that side, you can see I have a normal stress of 100 megapascal and the shear stress going downward of 40 megapascal. So the point coordinate of the reference point A is given as 100 comma negative 40. Now we can go ahead and point that thing on the graph as well. Just keep in mind, since it was negative 40 and our vertical axis is positive downwards, that's why I have point A on the upper side. Now joining point C to point A, this distance gives us the radius of the circle, and we can utilize the distance formula to calculate the radius. That is the sigma coordinate of A minus the sigma coordinate of point C square plus the tau coordinate of A minus the tau coordinate of point C square, and taking the square root of the whole give us our value of radius, that is coming as 56.56 megapascal. Now, once we have drawn our circle, let's go ahead and identify our principal stresses utilizing the information from our circle here. Now, by definition, principal stresses are the maximum or minimum normal stresses. In this case, if you look at the circle, the maximum point we are getting on the horizontal axis is identified as sigma 1. The value of that point can be calculated from our origin, that is the distance from origin to point C, that give us the distance of 60. And if we add the radius, that moves it to the value of sigma 1. So our sigma 1 value is 116.56 megapascal. On the other end, in order to identify the minimum normal stress acting on the circle, now this time subtracting the radius will put it on sigma 2, and the value is coming as 3.43 megapascal. Now, once we have the stresses, we still have to identify the orientation of the principal plane. So to do that, we will consider our reference line, that is from A to C, and calculate the angle this line is making from the horizontal sigma axis. So it is given as 2 theta p. Now, in order to identify the value of this angle 2 theta p, we can draw our right angle triangle and utilize some information from trigonometry. So in this case, if I look at the opposite distance of that right angle triangle, it is of negative 40. But we are going to just consider the magnitude of it in order to calculate the angle 2 theta p. whereas the adjacent of this right angle triangle can be calculated if I take the total distance of 100 and subtract that 60, it will give me the adjacent of that right angle triangle that is also coming as 40. Now we can go ahead and simplify and identify our angle by taking the tangent inverse of 1. So if we do that and put that in the calculator, the tangent inverse of 1 is equals to 45 degrees. Now, one more thing, this angle is measured in the clockwise direction as from our reference line CA, the plane where the principal stress is present is in the clockwise direction. So to draw that thing on the stress element, we will start with our horizontal x-axis, that is our reference plane, and the angle is in going in the clockwise direction of 22.5 degree. So we are going to draw our stress element making an angle of 90 degree with respect to this line. Now, since the angle was measured from the reference line going towards sigma 1, so the stress acting along this angle will be equals to 116.56 megapascal, whereas the angle 90 degree from that is where our sigma 2 is acting. So it is given as 3.43 megapascal. Now, once we have developed our stress element of the principal stresses, let's go ahead and look into maximum shear stresses and how we can get that value from the circle. So since we know that the vertical axis is of shear stress and the furthest away point from the origin is calculated basically by the radius of the circle. So the value of tau max is negative R, that is minus 56.56 megapascal. And for the orientation, we can again go ahead and measure the angle from our reference plane, that is from C to A. Now in this case, we are going to calculate the angle in the counterclockwise direction from the line CA going towards our radii value where the maximum shear stress line we have created. Now this angle is represented as 2 theta S, where the S is representing the shear stress subscript. So again, using our trigonometry, tangent function is equals to opposite over the adjacent. In this case, the value of opposite is basically 100 minus 60. That will give us our 40 distance, whereas the adjacent is also equals to 40. So the angle again in this case will be of 45 degrees. Next, we have to divide that with 2 in order to get the value of theta s that we will be utilizing to draw our stress element. Now, one thing to keep in mind, in this case, the value of theta s is 22.5, however, it is in the counterclockwise direction. So let's go ahead and draw that thing on our stress element. The process for that will be identical. We will start with the horizontal x-axis, that is representing our reference line CA, and then we are going in the counterclockwise direction from this axis at an angle of 22.5, and we are going to draw our stress element perpendicular to this line. So in this case, our squared is drawn perpendicular to the plane, which is making an angle of 22.5 with respect to the horizontal x-axis. Now, since the maximum shear stress is negative, so the sign convention is on the right-hand side of the squared, it's going to go downward, whereas on the left-hand side, it is pointing upward. Now, we also have to put on the complementary side, since the downward and upward is making our clockwise rotation. So on the complementary side, the arrowhead is represented in such a way that they are counteracting that particular effect. Finally, on the plane where the maximum shear stress occurs, the normal average stress are also present. So the average value of normal stress in our case was 60 megapascals, pointing in the outward direction, identifying the tensile direction of the average stresses.